I gather together this day to bring to God all our needs, all our thoughts, and all our sorrows. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done.
Who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever. You shall say to them, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord let his face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord uncover his face to you and bring you peace. This is how they are to call down my name on the sons of Israel, and I will bless them. The word of the Lord. O God, be gracious and bless us.
God, be gracious and bless us.
God, be gracious and bless us. And let your face shed its light upon us. So will your ways be known upon earth, and all nations learn your saving help.
O God, be gracious and bless us.
Let the nations be glad and exult, for you rule the world with justice. With fairness you rule the peoples. You guide the nations on earth.
O God, be gracious and bless us.
Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. May God still give us his blessing till the ends of the earth reveal.
O God, be gracious and bless us.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. When the appointed time came, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born subject of the law, to redeem the subjects of the law and to enable us to be adopted as sons. The proof that you are sons is that God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts. The Spirit that cries, Abba, Father, and it is this that makes you a son. You are not a slave anymore. And if God has made you his son, then he has made you his heir. The word of the Lord.
Given him before his conception. The God
Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
To be a missionary to the industry. This highlights the face of young people in the life of the community. Listening with the heart is all the more important as we face the future with fewer clergy. How are we going to fulfill our mission in these changing times? A group of clergy and laity have drawn out proposals to move forward positively in these changing times. However, there is a need for a wide consultation, and the group are currently preparing resources for this to happen. Like Mary, we may find our lives turned upside down, but if we are to be open to the Holy Spirit, changes can be positive and lead us in new and unexpected directions. In all of this, we ask for the prayer of Mary, Mother of God, and model of discipleship. Declan, Bishop of Clifton. The pastoral letter is available in hard copy in the church porch. It's also available on our parish website, and those of you who receive the newsletter via email, you received a copy of this pastoral letter yesterday. Just on a short note, you may have heard towards the end where Bishop Declan speaks of a group of clergy and laity drawing up proposals for a wide consultation on the shortage of priests. I'm on that little group, and it may be trouble ahead, but there is light at the end of the tunnel. We stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God,
Royal Wisconsin. loyal patron Lassie and our own parish, that our parish communities will be built on love and a powerful witness to the presence of God.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We ask the Holy Mother of God to pray with us and for us as we say,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
In the silence of our hearts, we turn to our Father with our personal intentions.
Lord, our God, you come very near to us, with a child born to clergy women. In the depths of darkness, you gave birth to light. In the depths of silence, which you brought forth the word. Grant that we who ponder these things in our hearts may recognize in her child our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
I sacrifice sanctuaries. May we make the sepulchres of God be your life and power. Just as we glory in the beginnings of your grace, so one day we may rejoice in its completion. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is true, right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord and Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the solemnity of the Motherhood of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, without losing the glory and virginity brought forth into the world. The eternal light. Through Jesus, the angels praise your majesty. May our voices be prayed over the days, to come and praise as we have in a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of that."
Until you come again.
We offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, like Nicholas, Laura, Patrick, Matthews, and family. For Pope Benedict, we pray that their souls may rest in peace, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Jesus.
Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Not for each other away. Thank you. Bless us. We have received this heavenly sacrament in joy of all. Grant, we pray, that it may lead us to eternal life. For we rejoice to proclaim the blessed ever Virgin Mary, mother of your Son and mother of the Church. Through Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Just to mention that our Mass on Thursday will be the Requiem Mass for John Murray, who sadly passed away just before Christmas. We keep John and his family in our prayers at this time. Also, as we know, another funeral will be taking place in Rome, the funeral of Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI, who, after a long and happy retirement, passed away peacefully yesterday morning. We keep Pope Benedict and also John Meredith in our prayers. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord,
and their perpetual life shall be. May they rest in peace. Amen.
Also, on a personal note, just a very big thank you to myself for all your kind words, all your Christmas cards and gifts, and Christmas collection over the Christmas period. Very generous. And the Christmas collection will be used wisely. Or maybe not. Hope you have a lovely, happy new year and many blessings for this year ahead. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is
over.
Thank you.